Hi guys!
Welcome back to Super Science!
By the end of this video, you will be expected to be able to describe the early ideas of the structure of atom that was proposed by Joseph John Thomson.
You should be then able to describe how the ideas of this scientist leads to creating this atomic model.
And lastly, you should be able to know the differences and similarities of the model to the other models.
This video is for educational purposes only, and we hope you like it.
So guys, what do we have here?
Look, here's a kind of cake.
This is not just a cake. Did you know that truly some kind of cake you said was used to illustrate an atomic model?
Oh, that's interesting.
So Candy, can you tell us what you know about this model?
Joseph John Thomson, an English physicist and a Nobel laureate in physics, is the one behind this model. He called this model the Plum Pudding Model.
Oh, I do know this person. He is the one who discovered electrons way back in 1897.
Yep, that's right.
Hey!
So, do you want to know how did he discover the electrons? Thomson performed an experiment called the cathode ray experiment, in which it leads to the discovery of the electron. In the experiment, Thomson took a tube made of glass containing two pieces of metal as an electrode. The air inside the chamber is subjected to high voltage and electricity flows through the air from the negative electrode to positive electrode. Thomson studied the passage of an electric current through a gas, in which the process states that as the current passed through the gas, it gave off rays of negatively charged particles. Atoms were made from positively charged substances with negatively charged electrons scattered about like raisins in a pudding.
Through that, Thomson came up with an idea to illustrate an atomic model from those scattering of electrons. Let's take this pudding as an example. The atom is composed of electrons surrounded by a sieve of positive charge to balance the electrons' negative charges. Like negatively charged raisins in this cake or plum in the model of Thomson's, in which it is surrounded by positively charged cake or pudding. The electrons were thought to be positioned throughout the atom in rotating rings. In this model, the atom was also sometimes described to have a cloud of positive charge. That is how the plum pudding model of Thomson's worked.
So, can we eat this cake now?
Of course, those lectures of mine made me hungry.
J.J. Thomson or Joseph John Thomson named his model the plum pudding because his favorite food is plum pudding. With this model, Thomson abandoned his earlier nebular atom hypothesis in which atoms were composed of immaterial vortices, and Thomson called the negatively charged particles corpuscles.
Now that you know the atomic model of Thomson, let's have a brief comparison of the different models that was proposed by other scientists before him. First, Democritus believed that atoms are tiny indivisible particles and continuously moving. Then, Aristotle's idea about the nature of matter were composed of fire, air, earth, and water and overshadowed Democritus' theory for 2,000 years. Later in the early 1800s, John Dalton proposed the billiard ball model that describes solid indestructible units much like a billiard ball and explains atoms of the same element are exactly alike and atoms of different elements are different. And then, a scientist made a major leap in science, which is Thomson, who discovered the electrons through his experiment, the cathode ray, and that he came up with an atomic model that describes is surrounded by negatively charged particles and the atom itself is positive in charge.
We hope that you have learned something in this video.
Thanks for watching.
Bye! Peace out!